Is there a disconnect between the National Disaster Management Unit and the National Disaster Operations Center? Now, it is emerging that there is an ongoing interagency row between the two organizations who are formed to respond to and prevent disasters. Now, the National Disaster Management Unit Acting Director, Pius Masai, in an exclusive interview with Ebru Africa TV, said that the center is sidelining them.
On August 7th, 2013, fire broke out inside the main terminal building at Jomo Kenyatta International Airport in Nairobi, destroying two of the three units. Property worth millions of shillings was reduced to ashes. President Uhuru Kenyatta visited the airport. It was observed that he was not pleased with how disaster agents responded to the tragedy. Then, National Disaster Operations Center, headquartered at Nyayo House, was in absolute control of disaster operations. The president then rubber-stamped the formation of National Disaster Management Unit to give a helping hand to the center.
Actually, National Disaster Operations Center is a good center, but it should coordinate issues when they are now reached at the national level, which will require support to various jurisdictions, and also when it requires assistance internationally, but should not interfere with the normal operations of other emergency disasters in Kenya. This is the role of National Disaster Management Unit, which is primarily distributed all over the country to deal with all emergencies and disasters in Kenya.
The Disaster Management Unit is accusing other agencies of sidelining them. Acting Director of National Disaster Management Unit, Pius Masai, says that some officers at Nyayo House, where National Disaster Operations Centers are housed, are not giving them information on disaster.
They underrate us, they undermine us, because we have been in forums. I wonder how a colleague of mine can tell the public on TV, can tell the public in forums that NDMU is not existence. Whereas he knows that we are there established under the presidential directive. We have national working documents which were actualized on 27th June 2014. And himself, before me, sitting in the forums, he says, NDMU, there's nothing like NDMU.
He is accusing the center handling them like competitors and not as partners.
NDMU was established because of the failures of some of the agencies. I don't want to name them, but we know who failed. Who failed in JKA fire? Who failed in Westgate? Because we did not have proper leadership, coordination, command and control. Just look and see in the past the few instances that we have managed, like the Makongeni building collapse, Huruma, the Kariza incidents, Naroko floods. We have had a lot of coordination with the stakeholders. And it's a matter of NDMU standing forward to give out clear leadership, command, control.
Well, all said and done, Kenyans hope that the two inter-agencies will embrace the spirit of teamwork to avoid compromising service delivery before, during, and after disasters.
We are now joined by the National Disaster Management Unit Acting Director, Pius Masai, who will update us on the status of our preparedness in responding to disasters as we also look at the interagency row and what it entails. Now, first and foremost, right now, where Kenya is with the various agencies that are working on disaster, are we prepared for a disaster? Should it happen now, God forbid?
At the moment, Kenya government is fully prepared for emergencies and disasters before, during, and after. And this is because after actualizing the operationalization of National Disaster Management Unit, which has brought sanity in incident management in Kenya. You remember before we had problem during Westgate, during the JKA fire, and the problem was clear leadership, coordination, command and control. In terms of resources, Kenya is rich. We have a lot of resources. If you look at the National Youth Service, the government has put a lot of resources for Kenya National Youth Service, which is our main key stakeholder in incident management in Kenya. If you require any equipment for search and rescue, for extrication, and also for any other duty in terms of incident management, National Youth Service have the capability. Why? Because they are among the first responders. They are not secondary responders.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Now, I like that you're talking with confidence in that the country should be able, we are prepared right now. But I think various circumstances that have come to pass have shown Kenyans otherwise. I mean, we had the Garissa attack, first and foremost. Second thing, I don't know, maybe it's a matter of terming what a national disaster is. We had the Garissa attack. We've had the crazy rains and floods that have hit Nairobi and parts of Mombasa and Narok. And in each of those situations, we've seen sort of delayed response in dealing with these sort of disasters. So what is it? Or is it that the preparation is centralized to parts of Nairobi or some parts of the country? Because we saw what happened in Narok and before anything could happen, before any grip on the situation could be taken, a lot of time had passed. So how can we say that we're ready when the situations have shown us otherwise?
Kenya is big, as you know, as a country. Incidents are managed using best practices. You saw what happens for Garissa. There was a threat for terrorist attack. And actually the response was very good. Only that special teams like the Rega team, which went and neutralized the terrorists, actually is based in Nairobi. We have advised the government very well that now we need more Rega teams displayed nearly all over in all counties.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because in incident management, what require most is timing. The timing should be what should save more lives and property. And it is important that we should have more specialized teams, as the Jeshu Rega team, displayed nearly all over in all counties. Why? Because in case if there is an attack, the response will be so quick. For the issue of the Narok floods, you understand that the weather has changed, and you understand that the climate change has made a lot of changes in terms of the Rift Valley. Because you find that the rains were at Mau, and flash floods came in Narok, town, causing a lot of havoc. What is the problem? The problem is during the impact assessment, which I was the incident commander in Narok, because I flew to Narok to assist the Narok County government, and I set up an impact assessment team. Through the preliminaries of the assessment, we realized that most of the buildings have been built in areas, lower areas, which used to be water passage. And what is important is long-term solutions are needed by Narok County governments. So far, I believe Narok government is now in a position coming up with the medium and long-term solutions. Because when we assessed, it's important that most of the buildings here in the water parts should have been knocked down, because you cannot stop water from flowing. What required is to open up the water parts.
All right.
Yes.
Just hand in hand with that, I like that you've talked about lasting solutions, because flooding and drought are things that we are not entirely foreign to. This is something that occurs one way or the other every single year in Kenya. But what we seem to be investing in, or what seems to be the number one way to deal with these disasters, seems to be post-action. You know, knee-jerk reactions. What can we do to deal with the issue after? Instead of, I think, focus on preventative measures. Do you think there's ever going to be a time when we can have a paradigm shift of sorts to actually focus on putting in and implementing the right preventative measures to ensure that these disasters don't happen? And what is the NDMU doing to see that some of these long-term solutions are actually implemented in these areas that are affected?
Disaster management should be every person concerned. And using community approach is the best.
Mm-hmm.
As National Disaster Management Unit, we focus so much 80% on mitigation and preparedness and 20% on response and recovery. And we'll find that if we focus most resources on mitigation and preparedness, we'll have good solutions. We are not reactive. What is important is disaster management should be a concern of every Kenyan, not only the National Disaster Management Unit. And that's why we have rolled out National Disaster Management, Disaster Risk Reduction activities, whereby we expect each and every person, each and every county, to identify the hazards and also identify possible solutions. You know, if you identify hazards within a county, sub-county, at community level, we'll be having a proper solution, because we'll identify the resources that you have and resources that we don't have, so that each and every county will be able to identify where and how and what time to get resources at the right time.
Mm-hmm.
What is important is it should be a concern of everybody, should not be a concern of one entity.
Tell us about some of the campaigns that you people have been spearheading to equip Kenyans with the right knowledge when it comes to disaster management, or how to react in the instance of a calamity or disaster.
In fact, what we are doing, we have rolled down a lot of sensitization in terms of all hazard incidents, in case of floods, fire, building collapse, terrorism. In fact, what we are doing now, we have rolled out a major campaign which is training and giving special paste guidelines and tips in that in case of an event of an attack, everyone, students, even the public, can be able to respond by hiding, by running away, and even fighting back, because terrorists are people who are ready to destroy life. However time you take negotiating with them will not assist. So what is important is to train our public that the game has changed. There is need for them to know how to have to learn the basic mechanism how they can defend themselves, so that we can save more life.
We've seen the Red Cross has been, ideally for the longest time possible, has been at the forefront when it comes to disaster management. I mean, anytime there's a calamity of sorts, or there's a problem of sorts, the Red Cross ideally is always the first agency that we see on the ground. Now, we see the relationship between the NDMU and the NDOC is a bit conflicted. What has the relationship been like with the Red Cross Society? You talked of, even in the piece that we saw earlier, that you feel like you're being treated as competitors and you're being sidelined. Would you say the state of relations is the same with the Red Cross?
First of all, I would like to thank His Excellency the President of Republic of Kenya, President Uhuru Kenyatta, because he realized that there was a gap in this country. After his benchmarking worldwide, he realized there's need to come with an interagency, and that's why he established National Disaster Management Unit as an interagency. And when we come out with the national documents, we were together with the NDOC and all other stakeholders, even the Kenya Red Cross, were part of the team which formulated the national documents, which are signed by the Honorable Joseph Olorengo on 27th June 2014.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, we should not hide under the table and take this country back. There's a need. A presidential directive is clear. There's a gap. And this gap was brought by some of the agencies which are still existing up to now. You understand that there are some failures in JKF fire, in Westgate, whereby resources were overwhelming. Instead of bringing the right resources, everything was just dominating the ground, which is wrong. The Kenya Red Cross has played a very important role in this country. Kenya Red Cross does not show competition. In incident management, we don't compete, but we complement each other. There's a lot of collaboration. In fact, the Kenya Red Cross are doing a good work, mm-hmm. and working with them in a good relation with other stakeholders. The problem here is National Disaster Operations Center. You know, when Mr. Mwandi was appointed as the director of National Disaster Management Unit, he went straight away to discuss and see whether he can take over from Mr. The retired Colonel Nathan Kikozo. But what happened? He never gave the chair to Mr. Mwandi. And Mr. Mwandi played it cool because he was nearing his retire and other reasons known to him. But actually, we should not take this country back. You can realize that since the establishment of National Disaster Management Unit, there's a lot of change in incident management. We have managed a lot of incidents. For example, Makongeni building collapse, I was the incident commander with other stakeholders. Red Cross were there. Kenya Defense Forces were there. Ruma incident, Roy Sambu, the Naroko floods. But the problem is our colleagues who are our interagency, which they have not devolved down the counties. We compliment them, of course. They are there in the Nyaya House. They should work as a team, complementing each other. The functions are very clear. National Disaster Operations Center have got only three functions, which are established for, and they are in black and white. The National Disaster Management Unit have got seven functions, clear functions.
Yes.
So I don't know. There's nothing conflicting here. What we need is a complementary role. But you find that when you are in forums, before stakeholders. My colleague in the National Disaster Operations Center tells stakeholders there's nothing existing like NDMU, whereas he knows that NDMU was established by his extensive president. And we are working. We have rolled out, devolved down to the counties, sub-counties, even to the community level. So what's the problem? We should not take the country back in the dark days. We should complement each other.
I don't know. It seems like a bit like a sibling rivalry, you know, where there seems to be a bit of a... Probably one agency feels like the other agency is stepping on each other's toes. My question to you is, we have two agencies here that are supposed to work together for the better of Kenyans to ensure that in the instance of a disaster, that the proper response and the proper preparedness policies are being implemented on the ground. You cannot tell me that it is solely on the NDOC that the conflict or the interagency row has occurred. We want to know what is at the heart of it. Why are the two agencies unable to work together in complementary? Is it the NDOC that's being the aggressor, or is it the NDMU?
For our side, we complement each other, madam. The functions are very clear. Our main function we are given is overall leadership, coordination, control, monitoring, response, and management of the disaster effort in Kenya. What you are doing? The second one is mobilization of resources and foster collaboration and partnership with other agencies on disaster risk management. The third one is planning and budgeting. The fourth one, training and capacity development of personnel. And the fifth, facilitating research on different aspects, trends of disaster management issues. The sixth one, monitoring and evaluation of DRR programs and activities. Mm-hmm. The seventh one, liaison with line ministries and national response efforts on private companies, equipment, hiring and competition, which is working very well. We have hired equipment for public, and the government has paid, government has paid. NDOC have three functions, very clear functions. In fact, they are supposed to coordinate and control disaster response efforts, to act as the command center for communication and information relating to response operations, and the third one to liaise with responsible ministries on national response efforts. This one, you know, the way Kenya is set up, the National Police Service was given the overall leadership in the agency because of our display in the country. Mm. The NDOC, they're in the Nyaya House, and they come in handy when issues are now at national level. We require resources from some other places we cannot get. Also, when you need resources from outside the country, they'll cooperate and coordinate the resources. Mm. But in normal incident management, the way we operate, we have emergency operation centers in every district, every county, whereby every report of Manenji, they call 99112, and then the response is activated. So there's no conflicting factors here. What people should do, let us work as a team as per our delegated functions.
All right.
Yes.
Thank you so much for that. I think we're much more clear above, I think, other things, the mandate. And I think Kenyans now are a bit more sensitized on, first and foremost, the disaster preparedness policy, where the country stands and what the conflict is. I think we just hope that it might not come in the way of actual response and operation when we're faced with such a calamity. But thank you so much, Mr. Masai, for coming. Trust we will be getting to you yet again, probably at a later date, so that we can discuss the disaster management policy in the country. Thank you so much for coming to studio.
Security begins with me and you.
Of course.
Actually, there is no conflict. What is there? Kenya is rich. We have a lot of resources. What was lacking is clear leadership, coordination, command and control. And NDMU have the capability because we have rolled down the activities down to the community, and we have the power. Thank you.
Thank you.